So with this one, we're going to really work on opening out and increasing the metabolism of the knee joints. So I'm going to start off by trying to sit on your desk if you can, or bring your chair up really high if you can't. And all you're going to do is sit there and swing your knees for a minute or two like you're a five-year-old on a swing. Now what this does, and I'll explain it while I'm going through it, I've got my shoes off because I'm about to knee on the chair. So what this does is it just helps to slightly stretch out the hamstrings at the back of the knee, not dramatically, but a little bit. It flushes out the knee joint, so it just encourages the synovial fluid in the knee joint to become more fluid. Now as that happens, we are slightly sort of squishing and stretching the knee joint. So that encourages metabolism, it encourages fresh fluid to come in, and it encourages the removal of waste products. So this feeds the cartilage by providing fresh nutrients into the knee joint. So we just do this for a minute or two, something like that, just get a nice rhythm going. And then either you just turn around and do this on your chair if you're sitting on your chair, or you come onto your chair. And you're going to hold on to the back of the chair as usual, she says. And my chair is, of course, turning really, really helpfully. But all I'm doing is shifting my weight from left knee to right knee as my chair decides to skate across the floor. But as I'm shifting my weight between my left and right kneecap, what I'm doing is I'm taking that lovely fresh synovial fluid that I've just sort of poured into my knees, and I'm squishing that into my joint cartilage. And that just feeds the cartilage at the back of the kneecaps, essentially. Now, I'm doing it on a soft surface for a reason. Most of us, when we're grown up, don't spend an awful lot of time kneeling on the floor. So our joints simply aren't in the habit of being able to kneel on the floor comfortably. So I'm always going to start this on a soft surface for as long as you need to. So my chair's nice and padded. I'm then going to come back down again, go back onto my desk, which is covered in plastic because I am currently spraying and cleaning it every 5 minutes for the coronavirus pandemic when I'm actually seeing patients in clinic. And I'm just going to carry on swinging my knees again. And I don't even have knee problems, but I can still feel that this feels more fluid somehow, more just easier. There's just more of a swing going on. It feels lighter and looser in my knees. And as I say, I don't even have knee problems, but I can already feel that. So there's another minute or so of doing that. I'm gonna come back onto my chair, shove it back so it doesn't try and take me halfway across the room, and then shift my weight left and right, trying to stop the chair from skating across the room, although frankly I think this could be a new Olympic sport. So again, just shifting my weight forwards and back, left and right, going around in circles over my kneecaps. So I'm just working my body weight over my kneecaps, but with my kneecaps on a soft surface. So if you're doing this at home, doing it on your chair is great if your chair is soft. But if your chair is not soft, then I would suggest doing it on a pillow on the floor, maybe even on your bed. But definitely have something soft under your kneecaps, particularly when you're starting out, because I've seen people irritate their knees with this exercise, and you shouldn't irritate your knees with this exercise if you are doing this on something soft enough. Again, can I come back? And this is the last round, so I've done two rounds in the chair now. So I'm going to be doing, essentially, we're going to be starting and finishing with the knee swings, and I'm going to do one more round of walking on my knees. So I'm just going to start, just getting my knees, they were going completely straight, but knees have got a little bit of twist in them as well. So what I'm trying to do now is just draw little circles in the air with my feet. So I'm getting a bit of sideways movement as well as a bit of forward and back. And again, that feels nice and loose and spacious compared to how I started. And I'm going to do one more round, get up onto my chair, try and anchor my blooming chair again. It's refusing to be anchored, frankly. I'm just going to disappear off around the room, I think, while I'm doing this. Yeah, I can feel that. I can feel those wheels manoeuvring themselves underneath me, but that's fine. I'm sort of holding onto the couch at the same time as holding onto the chair. It doesn't feel the safest thing I've ever done, but it could be worse. So just really working through those kneecaps and just encouraging all that lovely fresh synovial fluid just to squish its way into my cartilage. So the way I think of cartilage is being a bit like a sponge. You know how if you put a sponge in a glass of water, it will take on fluid, but if you keep squeezing that sponge, it will squeeze out all the air and get more fluid into it. And that's, it's a completely inaccurate explanation of what's going on, but it kind of feels like you're going to squeeze in more fluid if you just squeeze and let go, if you like. Squeeze and stretch. And so the final round is the stretch. So again, just coming back onto my desk and getting one more round, just swinging those knees out. And I usually find that within a few days of doing this, people start to feel that their knees are getting more comfortable. I should add that this is more, weirdly enough, for people with knee joint problems, so arthritis, stiff knees, just because we're getting old and creaky, more than it is for people who've actually got damage to the backs of their kneecaps. That may not be so comfortable. You might want to take a bit of weight off, have more weight on your hands if you've got actual damage to the cartilage at the back of the kneecaps. But for those of us who've just got stiff old knees, this is a brilliant exercise to start getting things going. There you go, knee swings and knee walking.